Hi, everybody. Welcome to Demo, the show where companies come in and they show us their latest products and platforms. Today, I'm joined by Nick Rennert. He is the field CTO at Kasada. Welcome to the show, Nick.
Thanks, Keith. It's a pleasure to be here.
So tell us a little bit about Kasada, what they do, and then what you're going to show us here today.
Yeah, well, we're a disruptive vendor in the bot mitigation space. It's an interesting industry, and the industry's been around for 10 years. Uh-huh. We're seeing big market shifts in terms of the types of problems that bots are causing, and there's a huge opportunity for a vendor like Kasada to step in and bring something different to the market.
Okay, and so the product that you're going to show is the whole platform, the Kasada platform, or is there a feature within that?
We're going to show how we mix our threat intelligence piece in with the bot mitigation piece. And that's really the angle that we've taken is, if you understand the mind of the adversary and how the bot developers work and the tools they use and how they use them, you've got a big advantage in terms of defending for your customers.
Okay, so obviously this is a security product, so I would imagine this is a designed for the security team. The main people who'd be using this would be on the security team?
Very much so. What's fascinating about bots, though, is that the problem that the bots cause is generally a business problem. So, you know, credential stuffing will translate into a fraud account takeover problem. Data scraping might turn into, you know, another business problem with maybe the analytics team.
Okay, and as quickly and briefly as you can, what problem are you solving? Like, you know, why should companies really care about the whole bot mitigation, process or bots in general? What's the big problem?
Well, yeah, the big problem is that we're a decade in and it's still an unsolved, non-stationary problem. What I mean by that is that, you know, as you roll something out into your product to try and stop bots, the bots respond. And so there's no level setting. There's no achieving the final product, as if you like. So the market's always in flux. It's very similar to email security. If you look at that industry over the last 30 years, market leadership shifted probably two or three generations. And we've got a very different vendor mix now than what we did back in the early 2000s.
Right. We keep hearing, like, in a lot of security spaces, it's an arms race between the good guys and the bad guys, and it's always like someone does something and then they catch up, or the other way around, right?
Well, very much so. Yeah. And that's a really difficult thing for vendors to deal with, because if you're dedicating R&D and engineering resources to solve a problem, but you've got no guarantee how long that solution is going to remain effective, it's a really interesting sort of balance to take.
So if companies did not have something like this, what would they be doing? Because, you know, there's other bot mitigation companies out there, correct?
There's a lot of people that have bot mitigation in their marketing.
Yeah.
A lot of the WAF vendors, you know, would claim that their WAF would do bots. But when you get to the sophisticated end, when you get to the people who really know how to build bots and how they know how to reverse engineer the controls that are put in front of them, there's not many that remain effective at that level, and that's really the game that we play in.
All right, so let's see the demo and let's see what Kasada can do.
So a little bit of background, if I may.
Yeah, sure.
So InQtel, who some may know as effectively the investment arm of the CIA, invested in Kasada as a tool that would be useful for the intelligence community several years back. And we've been working with them to really think about, well, how do we use threat intelligence as a concept to augment bot mitigation? And that's really the genesis of the thing that we think we do very differently.
Okay.
So we've gone out and we've infiltrated all the botting communities, and we bring back signals into our platform that help us understand who's getting attacked and when. And that's the beginning of every customer journey for Kasada. So what we've got on the screen here is effectively the story of one customer or customer now. And if we look at the top sort of timeline here, what we're looking at is a timeline of when they were getting attacked by the credential stuffing crews. And we're also able to determine what the credential stuffing crews were doing with the accounts once they were compromised. So in this case, it was a gift card attack. So this intelligence allowed us to see that problem without even having any connection to that customer, you know, and then start working with them to understand, right, well, the controls that they have in place today, be it their WAF or their CDN or whatever it was, are not effective at stopping this bot. And then from there, we can then go and, you know, continue the journey with regards to how the bot mitigation solution works.
Okay.
And so what we're seeing on the screen here on is we're seeing the actual accounts being compromised. So the volume of accounts and indeed, you know, the type of thing that's being compromised. So, you know, $400-$500 gift cards being sold to the fraud space underneath. Underneath that, we're actually tracking the adversaries. So we're able to see the groups that are attacking the different companies. So we get this really interesting data set, which is, you know, the timeline of the attack, you know, the magnitude of the attack, but also who, you know, which attack is doing most active on any given day, which is a fascinating piece of, you know, intel for us to work with.
Yeah. And then I like the bottom one. That's the chatter analysis.
It is.
Right. Like, so this is when you're doing a lot of analysis on how people are in the bot space or talking about all these attacks.
Well, the way these ecosystems work is the person that compromises the account has to sell them to someone. And so that communication all happens on social media, yeah. Telegram, Signal, those kind of tooling, Discord even. So we monitor all of that signal. And what you've got here is a timeline of when this customer was referenced in different chat groups over time. And so what you'll see there's a very big correlation, very strong correlation between when they're being attacked and when the chat is happening in the group. And you see this big influx over here, which is something very different. That's when the community starts complaining that it's no longer working, when we've put our control in place.
Right.
And that's always a fascinating dynamic for us and our customers to see, is you get that real-time feedback of when you do something to stop them, you get all the, what we call them, bot tears.
Right, right. Okay, so once you have this information as a company, what's like the next step? What do they do then?
Well, the next step is we would generally work with the customer to put our bot mitigation solution in place to stop that bot.
Yep.
So if we take a look at what it looked like for this particular customer, so they went live, about 2 or 3 weeks after the first signal went live. And in that first 30 days, they're sitting at 90% bot traffic. But if you look at that timeline at the top, massive spikes in effectively credential stuffing attacks that would have previously been effective. And this is the thing that we're working with customers to understand is, in many cases, a credential stuffing campaign might last for months, certainly weeks, before the organization will understand that they're being attacked. And so us bringing the threat intelligence to them as close to real time as possible and then putting this in place, it really helps them understand the problem. Which then solves the downstream issue of the fraud, the account, the customer complaints, all that sort of stuff.
Yep. Okay. And then obviously you're giving them insights on the different attacks. Then what's the next thing that they would do?
Well, then we would start breaking it down and help the customer sort of understand. Well, okay, so we can see this big spike of red traffic, which is bot traffic,
yeah.
What is it actually doing? Because that's the thing that customers really want to know is, first question is, well, what are they after? So you can see here on the screen here, we're able to break it down and profile the different types of attacks that we're seeing on behalf of that customer. And that really, at the exec level for that customer, really helps them understand, right, well, we've got this problem and it happens to be cred stuffing and the Akamai dashboard's telling us that, and the reports that we get from them sort of validate the problem that we were previously not able to detect. So really it's about, getting the Kasada piece in play. If we think about what that looks like, we integrate in with the customer's application infrastructure, typically a CDN, and then we'll effectively, what we're doing, like the secret sauce of Kasada is we're injecting, detection logic into the browser in this really highly secure JavaScript virtual machine. What that allows us to do is to collect data in a way that's very difficult for the adversaries to see, and then send it back to our ML models to make the decisioning as to whether it's a human or whether it's someone using a toolkit that we identify as bot.
So in an attack, like after they've deployed Kasada, does it stop the attack or just lets them know that the attack is going on and then protecting the data? Is that?
Well, in this instance, like we've got different models, right?
Yeah.
So we've got the monitor mode where we would tell them that it's happening, but we'd let the traffic through. And that's generally the first step in the integration process. But yep. The minute you move into protect, we're immediately stopping those attacks. Some customers like to take our signal and feed it into their models and they take the mitigating action. Our goal is to stop the attack, from the very first request. And that's effectively the role of that detection logic inside the browser is to feed us the data that gives us the confidence that it's a bot from the very first time
okay.
we see it.
And is this relatively easy for an IT group or a security group to install within their own networks?
Well, the great thing is, firstly on our side, there's no config that they need to learn. The onboarding process from the Kasada perspective is really simple. Like it's a turn it on and off sort of process. There's a few little things you can tweak to customize it to your own internal needs, but you don't need to know how we detect bots in order to configure our product, which is a really important thing. Most customers will turn this into protect mode on day one and they're with full confidence that we're blocking with high degree of accuracy.
All right, and you you offer a free trial, a free version, 30-day version, anything like that?
We do, yeah. 30 days is our general POC. Great opportunity for us. We do it in production. We put it into blocking mode. We put our money where our mouth is with regards to our product. It's a great opportunity for us to learn more about our customers, to help them understand what we see. We're great storytellers at Kasada. We understand the data really well, and we've got the ability to sort of translate that into the business logic that a lot of our security teams need in order to talk to their business owners.
And I know you've got a lot of other features there, so where can people go to learn more about the product?
Well, Kasada.io is probably the best place. Okay. We've spent a lot of time and thought working out what content to put on there. But we're obviously super interested in doing a live demo with customers, coming out and talking about, the nuances of how we work and how the product works. And in this sort of phase of the bot mitigation industry where many are failing, and where Gen AI is really disrupting the defense model, I think it's really important that people take another look at how bot mitigation is working in 2024 and beyond.
One more thing. So you mentioned at the beginning of the episode that you've infiltrated a lot of these networks. Do they know that you've been infiltrating? We're not like revealing any secrets here, are we?
Some do. Yeah, some do. So we obviously, there's different communities depending on the problem that you're solving. Yeah. So the cred stuffing group is all underground. They're very black hat. So they would be less aware. But it'd be very difficult for them. The sneaker bot community, they're very aware that we're there. We have an ongoing dialogue with them. The interesting thing about that community is, whilst we've got a very good reason to stop them from participating or consuming our clients' websites, they're not doing anything illegal. And that's the interesting thing about bot mitigation is there's plenty of examples of where the thing that the botters are doing is not illegal. And so they're more open to being, open with communication. And it's not unusual for Sam and I to be having chats with them in the background. We learn a lot through that. We understand the tooling that they use and how that ecosystem works.
All right, Nick, again, fascinating stuff. Thanks again for coming on the show and showing us this stuff.
No worries. Thanks, Keith.
That's all the time we have for today's episode. Be sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and add any thoughts you have below. Join us every week for new episodes of Demo. I'm Keith Shaw. Thanks for watching.